रामायण इंडियाज ग्रेटेस्ट हिस्टोरिकल एपिक अलोंग साइड द महाभारत. इट कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ नियरली 24,000 वर्सेस, मोस्टली सेट इन द अनुष्टुप छंद, डिवाइडेड इंटू 5 कांडास, द अयोध्या कांड, द अरण्यक कांड, द किष्किंधा कांड, द सुंदरा कांड एंड द लंका कांड एंड अबाउट 500 सर्ग. द स्टोरी ऑफ श्री राम्स लाइफ वॉज फर्स्ट नरेटेड बाय महर्षि Valmiki in the Ramayana, which was written after Shri Ram was crowned as the king of Ayodhya. Maharishi Valmiki had a great sense of astronomy, as he had made sequential astronomical references on important dates related to the life of Shri Ram, indicating the location of planets in the zodiac constellations and other visible nakshatras. However, today the existence of Lord Ram is considered to be a matter of debate. In this video, we are going to discuss certain pieces of evidence of Ramayana based on the textual, astronomical, geological and archaeological references from the epic.
Adi Kavi Valmiki in Ramayana has given details that Shri Ram was born on the Navami of the Chaitra Masa during daytime, when the position of different planets in the zodiacal constellations and nakshatras was as follows. The Sun was in Aries, Saturn in Libra, Jupiter in Cancer, Venus in Pisces, Mars in Capricorn, the lunar month of Chaitra, 9th day after Amavasya, Lagna as Cancer, Moon near the star Punarvasu in Gemini constellation, Moon and Jupiter were shining together in Cancer. When these descriptions are entered in a planetarium software, the results indicate that this was exactly the location of planets and stars on 10th of January at noontime in the year 5114 BC, if viewed from the latitude or longitude of Ayodhya. Thus, Lord Rama was born on 10th of January in 5114 BC. It was found that this date also happened to be the 9th day of Shukla Paksha in Chaitra Masa, and the time was around 12 to 1 noontime. This is exactly the time and date when Ramanavami is celebrated all over India.
In Valmiki Ramayana, it is mentioned in Ayodhya Kanda that Dasharath wanted to make Shri Ram the king because Sun, Mars and Rahu had surrounded his nakshatra, and normally under such planetary positions, the king dies or becomes a victim of conspiracies. The zodiac sign of King Dasharath was Pisces and his nakshatra was Revati. This planetary position was prevailing on the 5th of January 5089 BC, and it was on this day that Shri Ram had to leave Ayodhya for 14 years. Thus, he was 25 years old at that time, that is from 5114 BC to 5089 BC. And there are several shlokas in Valmiki Ramayana which indicated that Shri Ram was 25 years old when he left Ayodhya for his 14 years of exile.
They went to Tamsanadi, which is 20 kilometers from Ayodhya. Thereafter, they crossed the Gomati River and reached the banks of the Sharayu River. After crossing the boundary of Koshala Desha, they entered Shrungavarapura, which was the kingdom of Nushadraja Guha, and is famous for Kevat taking them across Ganga in his boat, 20 kilometers from Allahabad. After crossing the Yamuna near Sangam, they reached Chitrakoot on Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh borders. The memorials here include Valmiki Ashram, Mandavya Ashram, Bharatakupa, etc., which still exist. After Bharatamilap, they left Chitrakoot and went to Atri Ashram, located in the Satana in Madhya Pradesh.
Along with Lakshman and Sita, Shri Ram extensively travelled through this land of rivulets, water bodies and dense forests in and around Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. They roamed around in the Dandakaranya area and visited Sharabhanga and Sutikshana Muni ashrams in Satna. Thereafter, they visited several Rishi ashrams in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh area along Narmada and Mahanadi rivers for 10 years and then came back to Sutikshana ashram. Several memorials in Panna, Raipur, Bastar and Jagdalpur still exist, which include Mandavya Ashram, Shringi Ashram, Ram Lakshman Mandir and Koti Maheshwar, etc.
Lord Ram, Lakshman and Sita travelled along the Godavari from Agastya Ashram Then they went to Panchavati, a place with 5 Vatavriksha located on the banks of the Godavari River in Nashik. This place is famous for the Shurbanaka episode and war with Khara and Dushana. There are memorials at the place where Marich was stated as killed. These include Mrugavyadeshwara and Baneshwara. Nashik area is full of memorials, for example, Sita Sarovar, Ramakund and Trimbakeshwar, as well as Janasthana, etc. After this incident, Sita was abducted by Ravana, who also killed Jatayu, relating to the memorial Saravatiratha in Take village, 56 kilometers from Nashik, and it is still preserved. Ramayan refers to the solar eclipse at the time of the war with Kharadushana in the latter half of the 13th year of Sri Rama's stay in the forests. Valmiki has also mentioned that it was Amavasya and the planet Mars was in the middle. When this data was entered, the sky view generated by the computer software indicated that there was a solar eclipse on 7th October 5077 BC, which could be seen from Panchavati, which is 20 degrees north and 73 degrees east. On that date, the planetary configuration was the same as has been described by Valmiki, that is, Mars was in the middle, on one side were Mercury, Venus and Jupiter, and on the other side were the Sun, Moon and Saturn.
Shri Ram and Lakshman extensively travelled through these areas in search of Sita. After meeting Jatayu and Kabandha, they moved towards the south to reach Rishyamukh Parbat. On the way, they visited Shabri Ashram in Pampa Sarovar area, which is now known as Sureban in Belgaon, and is still famous for Shabri ke Ber trees. After crossing forests of sandalwood, many gardens and water bodies, they went toward Rishyamukh. Here, they met Hanuman and Sugriv and were shown Sita's ornaments. Shri Ram killed Bali in this area. Rishyamukh and Kishkindha are located in Hampi, Bellary district of Karnataka. Ram with his Sena marched towards the sea. After crossing Malay Parbat, Chandan forests, many rivers and ponds, they went along the Kaveri River. After crossing Trishirapalli, Thanjavur and Ramanathapuram, they reached Rameshwaram. Almost all the details of travel narrated in these 5 phases in Valmiki Ramayana tally with the existing geographic locations and memorials preserved. In Kishkindha Kanda, there is a reference to the solar eclipse on the day Bali was killed. The software shows a solar eclipse on 3rd April 5076 BC, which was the only solar eclipse during the entire year. Skyview reveals a lunar eclipse starting from 4:15 pm on 12th September 5076 BC from Colombo, 7 degrees north, 80 degrees east. In Sundarkand, there is a reference to lunar eclipse when Hanuman spots Sita in Ashok Vatika. Valmiki Ramayana contains graphic and poetic details of 8 constellations during Hanuman's return journey from Sri Lanka to Sunab Hill in the middle of the sea, which took about 4.5 hours from 6:30 am to 11 am. All these details of planets and nakshatras concerning 8 constellations described in Sarga 57 of Chapter 5 tally exactly with the sky view generated by the software for the morning of 14th September 5076 BC from Lanka. Based on planetary configurations described in various other chapters of Valmiki Ramayana, the date on which Ravan was killed works out to be 4th December 5076 BC, and Shri Ram completed 14 years of exile on 2nd January 5075 BC, and that day was also Navmi of Shukla Paksha in Chaitraman. Thus, Shri Ram had come back to Ayodhya when he was 39 years old, that is 5114 BC to 5075 BC.
Indian history has recorded that Shri Ram belonged to the Surya Vamsha and he was the 64th ruler of this dynasty. Most of the names of these ancestors of Lord Ram have been listed in the Valmiki Ramayana itself as narrated by Vasishtha Muni to Raja Janak. Almost all the major genome studies carried out so far have revealed an amazing correlation of this genealogy with the genetic profile of humans settled in the north, south, east and west of India from the Holocene, which is about 11,000 years before present. Almost all the important studies in paleoanthropology, including those carried out by Kenneth A.R. Kennedy and Cavalli Safrosa, have concluded that the genetic profile of the people of the Indian subcontinent has remained the same for the last 55,000 years, and that for the last 11,000 years, this profile is of culturally developing people who had started speaking a structured language.
Even after these pieces of evidence, you might still choose to be skeptical and say that Lord Rama is a mythical character. This is the legend of the man who gave up his kingdom on his father's word, who traveled thousands of miles on foot and crossed an ocean to rescue his wife, who exhibited compassion at every step of his way without a single shred of hate, a man who never went back on his word and stayed true to his actions, a man who never transgressed from his path, and above all, he was the man who repented killing the abductor of his wife. And when he was asked, why should he repent for killing Ravan? He answered, I killed Ravan for the sin he committed. But in that, I have also killed 9 other good qualities of Ravan, which made him a great man. And I must repent for ending those 9 qualities of Dashanana.
Shri Ram moved from place to place to spread the message of unity by showing a very high level of respect for the people from backward tribes and those considered untouchable. He embraced Guhanishad, who belonged to a lower caste. He gave a strong message against untouchability by eating with great affection the juta berries of Bhilni or Shabari. He sent his wife and children to be brought up and educated by Maharshi Valmiki, who is stated to be a Shudra but was a great scholar in the ancient world. Shri Ram tried and succeeded in establishing victory of good over evil. He helped the rishis and munis in living a life of honor. He got the kingdoms of small noble kings restored to them and acted as the biggest unifying factor. Such was the greatness of this king named Rama, who might be a mythical character to some people. But even if we consider him as a mythical character from a story written by sage Valmiki, he depicts the epitome of being an ideal human. After all, that is what stories are for, to inculcate values like morality, compassion, and righteousness. Only if people had truly understood what Lord Ram represented, irrespective of him being real or mythical, the world would have been a better place. Let's try to follow his ideals rather than worshipping his idols. Stay tuned, stay educated. And last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Panthanaha Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.